الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، فنتابع درسنا في قراءة والتعليق على كتاب في سير العلام شرح عمدة الأحكام للحافظ عبد الغني بن عبد الواحد المقدسي رحمه الله تعالى، مع شرحه في سير العلام للشيخ العلامة عبد الله بن عبد الرحمن البسام رحمه الله. So we're continuing the class and going over the book and benefiting from the book, the explanation of Umdat al-Ahkam by Hafiz Abdul Ghani and Abdul Wahid al-Muqdisi rahimahullah, as explained by Shaykh Abdullah bin Abdul Rahman al-Bassam rahimahullah in his book Taysir al-Allam. وَلَازِمْنَا فِي كِتَابِ الصَّلَاةِ فِي بَابِ الْخُشُوعِ فِي الصَّلَاةِ. We're still in the book of the prayer in the chapter regarding mindfulness and tranquility in the prayer. ذكرنا الحديث الذي أورده المصنف رحمه الله، وهو الحديث الذي يتعلق بالكساء الذي أهدي للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فشغله عن صلاته فرده إلى أبي جهم وطلب الأنبجانية بدلا منه، وهو الكساء الذي ليس فيه خطوط وأعلام. We already mentioned the hadith that the author rahimahullah mentioned regarding this matter, which is the hadith that the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam received a gift of a garment or a piece of clothes that had stripes, and then it distracted him in the prayer because he looked at the stripes, and the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam returned it back to the person who gave him this gift, who was Abu Jahm radiallahu anhu, and he asked instead for a piece of clothes that did not have stripes. وذكرنا الحديث وذكرنا فوائد الحديث. We already mentioned the hadith and the benefits that we take from the hadith. ووصلنا إلى كلام ذكره المصنف رحمه الله وذكره الشيخ الشارح رحمه الله من كلام شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله فيما يتعلق بالوساوس في الصلاة. And we reach some discussion that a sheikh in his explanation mentioned, which is statement from شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله regarding having doubts in the prayer. قال شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله، قال شيخ عبد الله البسام، قال شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله، الشيخ عبد الله البسام رحمه الله سد شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية سد: ولا ريب أن الوساوس كلما قل في الصلاة أو الوسواس كلما قل في الصلاة كان أكمل. So he said, the less the person has doubts in his prayer, the better and the most correct and perfect his prayer is. والذي يعين على ذلك شيئان. What helps and aids in that is two things. قوة المقتضي وضعف الشاغل. The strength of the reason or the having the causes of for having tranquility and concentration in the salah, and the reducing that which preoccupies the person. أما الأول فاجتهاد العبد في أن يعقل ما يقوله ويفعله. As for the first one, it is for the person to strive to pay attention and ponder upon what he is saying and what he is doing. ويتدبر القراءة والذكر والدعاء, and to also pay attention to his recitation and his supplication and his remembrance of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. ويستحضر أنه مناج لله تعالى كأنه يراه, and to also try to think and understand that he is calling out to Allah سبحانه وتعالى as if he can see him. فإن المصلي يناجي ربه, because the person who is praying is actually calling out to his Lord سبحانه وتعالى. والإحسان أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه. Perfection is to worship Allah سبحانه وتعالى as if you can see him. فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. And if you are not able to reach that point, then you should pray as knowing and realizing that he sees you. ثم كلما ذاق العبد حلاوة الصلاة كان انجذابه إليها أوكد. The more the person finds the sweetness of the prayer, the more he is inclined to pay attention to it. وهذا يكون بحسب قوة الإيمان, and that depends upon the person's strength and belief. والأسباب المقوية للإيمان كثيرة, and the means of increasing one's iman are many. فإن ما في القلب من معرفة الله, what the person finds in his heart from knowing Allah سبحانه وتعالى, ومحبته, and the love of Allah, وخشيته, and the fear of Allah, وإخلاص الدين له, and being sincere in his acts of in his religion and in his acts of worship to Allah, وخوفه, and the fear of Allah, ورجائه, and the hope for his reward and for Allah, والتصديق بأخباره, and to believe in that which he informed us of, وغير ذلك, and other than that, مما يتباين الناس فيه ويتفاضلون تفاضلا عظيما. So other than this, from the matters that people are different and are at different levels in regards to,
ويقوي ذلك أو ويقوى ذلك كلما ازداد العبد تدبرا للقرآن وفهما ومعرفة بأسماء الله وصفاته وعظمته.
That increases the more the person ponders upon the Quran and understands the Quran. Also, the more the person comes to know and understand the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the might and exaltation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His superiority subhanahu wa ta'ala.
وأظهر فقره إليه في عبادته واشتغاله به.
And also this increases by way of humbling oneself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, showing his need to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, being busy with the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
فإنه لا صلاح له إلا بأن يكون الله هو معبوده الذي يطمئن إليه ويأنس به ويلتذ بذكره ولا حصول لهذا إلا بإعانة الله ومتى لم يعنه الله على ذلك لم يحصله ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله.
Because the rectification of the person and the acts of worship that the person does cannot be done except by knowing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that he worships, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone with no partners, and he finds comfort and happiness and peace in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also to find the sweetness of the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he cannot achieve that except with the help and the aid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not aid him and help him with that, he will never achieve that. And there is no might and no movement and no ability except with Allah and by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
قال والثاني يعني القسم الثاني وهو زوال الموانع والأشياء التي تمنع هذا الخشوع وتدفع هذا الوسواس في الصلاة.
He said, ask for the second, meaning and referring back to his original statement that the second means and the second way of removing doubts in the prayer and being distracted in the prayer.
قال زوال العوارض.
He said, is to remove the things that come upon the person.
وهو الاجتهاد في دفع ما يشغل القلب من تفكر الإنسان فيما لا يفيده في عبادته.
It is to strive that the person pushes away from his heart any thinking about things that do not benefit him in his worship.
فيما لا يفيده في عبادته وتدبر الجوادب التي تجذب القلب على عن مقصود الصلاة. وهذا في كل عبد بحسبه.
And to also keep away everything that distracts the person from what is intended in the prayer. And that depends upon the person.
فإن كثرة الوسواس أو الوساوس بحسب كثرة الشبهات والشهوات.
The doubts come because of having excessive desires or doubts in regards to the religion.
وتعليق القلب بالمحبوبات التي ينصرف القلب إلى طلبها.
And also for the heart to be connected with things that one desires, which one seeks and aims to achieve.
والعبد الكيس يجتهد في كمال الحضور.
The wise person strives to be present and to be mindful in his prayer.
ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم.
And there's no might and no ability and no change and no movement except with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
ثم ذكر المصنف بعد ذلك باب الجمع بين الصلاتين في السفر.
After that, the author رحمه الله, he mentioned the chapter regarding combining the two prayers in the prayer in travel when one is traveling.
ونؤجل هذا الباب أو البداية في هذا الباب للدرس القادم إن كان في العمر بقية.
And we will delay speaking about this topic until next class, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows us to. ونكتفي بهذا المقدار.
وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين.